Hey everyone, it's Lena here, and in this short video, I'm excited to show you how to make music with Cubase and KeyLab Essential. Let's dive in. Cubase comes with a dedicated KeyLab Essential MIDI script, which allows KeyLab Essential to be recognized instantly after launching it alongside your DAW. However, it's good to make sure to use the latest DAW versions to ensure the best KeyLab Essential experience. Now, let's explain what we can control inside of Cubase with KeyLab Essential. Let's begin with the main encoder. The main encoder allows you to effortlessly navigate through your tracks in Cubase. By clicking the main encoder, you can conveniently show or close the selected plugin, providing quick access to your desired sound. Next, we have knobs 1 to 8. These versatile knobs serve a dual purpose. They allow you to control various parameters of the currently focused plugin in Cubase, enabling precise sound shaping. Additionally, when working in the mixer view, these knobs can adjust the panning of the focus track, giving you complete control over the stereo image. Moving on to the faders 1 to 8, they offer seamless control over the sends of the corresponding track in a Cubase. This allows you to have hands-on control over your effects. Additionally, when operating in the mixer view, these faders provide intuitive volume control for the corresponding tracks, allowing you to achieve the perfect balance in your mix. Now, let's explore knob 9 and fader 9. These dedicated controls provide direct access to the volume and pan settings of the selected track in Cubase. Whether you're fine-tuning the level of a specific instrument or adjusting the stereo placement, these controls ensure precise adjustments with ease. Furthermore, in the mixer view, knob 9 and fader 9 allow you to control the volume and pan of the master track, giving you overall control of your mix's final output. Let's move on to the contextual buttons. Contextual button number 1 serves as a toggle switch between device, meaning instruments or effects and mixer control modes, providing you with the flexibility to seamlessly switch between editing parameters and adjusting mix settings. Contextual button number 2 allows you to arm or disarm the selected track in Cubase, simplifying the process of preparing your tracks for recording or playback. Contextual button number 3 functions as a mute button, enabling you to quickly mute the selected track in Cubase. This can be handy when you want to silence specific parts of your arrangement. Lastly, contextual button number 4 provides a solo function, allowing you to isolate the selected track and focus on its individual elements. Moving on to the transport section, we have the play, stop, record, and loop buttons. These buttons are self-explanatory and allow you to control the playback and recording of your music. Let's explore the pads on the KeyLab Essential. In Bank A mode, pressing the pads triggers sounds, giving you instant access to creative ideas and rhythmic elements in Cubase. On the other hand, in Bank B mode, the pads offer a range of convenient Cubase functions, providing quick shortcuts for various actions within the DAW. Pad 1 adds an instrument track, while pad 2 duplicates elements. Pad 3 allows you to render your work, while pad 4 provides quick access to editing channel settings. Pad 5 simplifies the setup of project synchronization, and pad 6 facilitates the creation of chord events. Pad 7 enables you to freeze or unfreeze selected tracks. And pad 8 conveniently shows or hides the lower zone, enhancing your workflow. Lastly, if you're using Analog Lab, it's important to link the correct device when opening the plugin. By selecting the Arturia program button, you can enter analog lab mode, which provides seamless integration and precise control over the plugin. In this mode, you can navigate, select presets, and apply effects just as you would in standalone mode. Okay, that's really it. Hopefully this video demonstrates how quick, easy, and fun it is to use KeyLab Essential with Cubase. For more detailed information on KeyLab Essential and how to use it, make sure to watch the rest of our how-to videos on our channel. Thanks for watching and see you soon.